Okay, get back to this thing here. I've been penciling in details in here. Back pockets. There's the back of his thing, and there's the front. And I brought down an old pair of overalls here, just so we get the details right. Don't like to get the details wrong. So here on the side, make a mark down here basically about where that's going to go. And you can see here, like I was mentioning before, you don't button that top button. So that's going to come out just a little, just about like that. Not much. Just sort of like that right there. But first, let's go ahead and... Judy's shaking her head about something, I don't know what.
I was trying to go in to see it.
But see what?
Here.
Anyway, let's go ahead and do these pockets. First, let's just turn this over to see if we got them right. Gee, didn't know my butt was that big. Anyway, so let's just go across here. I basically got them already sketched in there. Let's just draw a seam down the center here. Now, when you're doing pockets, if you use a knife, just take your knife and screw it, get it in there like that, and just turn it out. That's all you need right there. It's just that little shadow line. Just like that. And you can come back and kind of dress that up just a bit. See that? Here. And a few times you go straight in. We're going to do something with one of these pockets, but I'll go ahead and carve them on here anyway. Shallow. Just real lightly indicate that side. Keeps pulling my head back out of the way. She has to forget there's a mirror there for. After you do that, always go back and relax those edges. People have a hard time with wrinkles, but if you carve a few of them, once you learn how they work, they're not that hard to carve at all. There we go, we got that part done. I guess we could go ahead, well, I'm not going to do that. I was going to go ahead and do the seam, but I just ain't going to do that. Okay, now for the side, let's get that out of the way. So this one, we're going to have just a slight little curve right here, down to that point right there. Then we'll come into that. Like that. Pick out that chip. Clean that up. And then we're just going to carve a little. This thing will just go out on Danny's leg, which we'll add that later. Okay, pants just curve on up. Little neckerchief. Okay, you saw that there, what I did. So we just won't mess with this side over here. We'll just move on around to the front. Okay, just off center here, we have the zipper, or the buttons in this case. Overalls don't have zippers. And then right around the midpoint of the thing there, we got that seam running across here. And then we got a seam right above that. And a short seam here. It's really quite long, isn't it? And now we got his pocket. I had a sketch there, but I'm going to move it over just a bit. Way down below the side buttons. And we'll carve that in. It's up to that seam. Now when you're wearing overalls or you're wearing any pants, the more you stick your hands in your pockets, the more this area right here gets stretched out. So we need to carve that in a little bit to indicate that there is a little more space there than normal. Angling my knife in more to make it get a stronger shadow line from the front. See there? pencil in our button, which is about right there. And the other one will be about right up there. But we're not going to do anything with those, because I think for these buttons, what we're going to do, we want a nice button that sticks up and out like these do. See here, how they stick up and out. And I think to accomplish that, we can just use some small brads, which will be just about the scale of those buttons right there. So let's continue on here. Slightly indicate this seam running across too. That a little. Sliver here. Like that. Let's just. That's got a zipper on it. Normally those things have buttons. So there'd be about a button there, button there, button there. So to show there's some button there, what we can do is just right there where that button is, just kind of take a little chip. Like that one there. Just take a little chip out. Same here. It just gives a little indication of something's causing those wrinkles or something under there. There, so there's a buttonhole right there. Just make your stab mark in there like that. We got a little notch. It creates that. See what else we can do here. First, let's go ahead. Turn that off. I'm not going to really work up in here much until I get my arms attached. Get too detailed here. That'll be about it for this video. We've hit the 15 minute mark. And I don't want to go too far beyond that. So, we're getting there. Slowly but surely. So in the next video, we'll just continue going right on up here until we reach the top. And then it'll come time to figure out what we're going to do with these arms. So until next time, I'll talk to you later. Looking pretty good.